Hay House Incorporated presents Spirituality is for Everybody. 8 accessible, inclusive ways to connect with the divine when living with disability. Written by Allison V. Thompkins, PhD. Read by Shellynne Vontoure. This audiobook includes a supplemental PDF that contains exercises, end notes, as well as the About the Author section from the print edition. I will be referring to the PDF throughout the recording, so be sure to have it handy as you listen. It should be among the files you downloaded when you purchased this audiobook. Please note that this audiobook contains meditations that should not be practiced while driving or operating heavy machinery. Two notes on language. Disability language. Within the disability community, there are two dominant ways we refer to our disability status. Identity first language, that is, disabled person, and person first language, that is, person with a disability. Throughout this book, you will notice that I use both identity first language and person first language, as well as terms such as lives with a disability. My reason for using such a wide range of language to describe disability is quite simple. I am a spiritual being having a human incarnation. I am a spirit, not a body. I have a body, but I'm so much more than my right index finger or my left knee or a hair follicle on my scalp. As a spirit, I'm part of the divine that is not bound or defined by the physical. However, I do understand that my spirit is just one part of me, the most important part, but not the only part. My body is another aspect of my being. I am a spirit who has been given a body to use as a tool. Thus, I combine my spirit with the experience of living with my body to express the divine in a way that only I can. I'm a proud member of every category my body fits into: Black, disabled, a woman, an American, on and on. All of these identities have come together to form the lens through which I experience the world that is unique to me, and through which I express the divine. My life with cerebral palsy, CP, has shown me truths such as the strength of the spirit to overcome physical limitations, the need to march in the streets to demand equal rights, and the depth of God's love for me through the presence of continuous miracles. Thus, I use an eclectic body of language to describe disability because my language must reflect the breadth of my lived experience, from the spiritual to the physical. Living with disability is a multifaceted adventure, and any attempt to describe disability requires a plethora of terms. I understand some people in the disability community only use identity first language or person first language. If you staunchly use one or the other, please feel free to imagine that I wrote this book using your preferred disability language. Use of the word God. I use the word God quite a bit throughout this book because this is a book about spirituality, and God is one of the ways I'm most comfortable talking about spirituality. However, I understand that the word God can be a trigger for some. If you do not care for or have an aversion to the word God, I invite you to replace it with any other word that you feel comfortable using as you listen to this audiobook. God does not care what you call it, and using the word God is by no means a prerequisite for having a deep, beautiful spiritual practice. God will respond with equal love, grace, majesty, and power if you call it God, the divine, the loving presence, the universe, spirit, or something else. One of the keys to spiritual practice is to acknowledge that there is a loving entity that exists throughout all space and time, that this entity has far greater power than any human being, and that this entity only wants the best for you. As long as you are sincere in your desire to meet it, God does not put restrictions on what it wants to be called. God simply wants you to show up to your relationship with it fully as yourself. How to use this book. Spirituality and spiritual practices have become more popular and more mainstream than ever before, and at the same time, society has become increasingly inclusive of those with disabilities. However, discussions about how to apply spiritual principles to the lived experience of disability seem elusive, and finding a guide on modifying spiritual practices for those with various disabilities can be challenging. This book aims to remedy both situations. Since this book is intended to address the experiences and needs of those living with disabilities, a logical question is, just who do I include in my definition of disability? I use an inclusive definition of disability. This book is geared toward those who have visible disabilities, non-apparent disabilities, or both. Those with physical disabilities, intellectual disabilities, cognitive disabilities, chronic illnesses, sensory disabilities, learning disabilities, communication disabilities, psychiatric disabilities, and those who are neurodivergent will find spiritual exercises included in this book that have been modified with their needs in mind. While there are different ways of understanding spirituality, this book discusses spirituality through the lens of metaphysics. Worry not if you don't have your high school physics textbook on hand or you never took physics. Metaphysics is not the same as physics. Metaphysics is the science of transcending the physical and teaches us that the solution to any situation experienced in the physical world lies in the spiritual world. We only need to bring the solutions found in the spiritual world to the physical one. As you may have guessed, according to metaphysics, two worlds exist: the physical world and the spiritual world. Within the physical world are body's senses, sight, touch, smell, sound, and taste, tell us that each person is separate from all other individuals on this planet, and that every entity that exists within creation is separate from all other entities, be they planets, animals, stars, flowers, etc. The physical world can seem more real than the spiritual world because the physical is tangible. Depending on our abilities, we can taste, touch, feel, hear, and/or see things in the physical realm. Because of the signals we receive from our senses, it's tempting to disregard the spiritual world and exist only in the physical. However, if we are only aware of and operate solely in the physical world, we are cutting ourselves off from the realm of infinite knowledge that is essential to living a full life and solving the problems that come our way. Conversely, within the spiritual world, every living being is one with all other beings because we were all created by the same force, which I call God. We are consciously aware of our connection to God and our ability to tap into it. Any challenge that arises in the physical world can be handled by going to the spiritual world. While many believe that the power to handle any situation and to create what we want for ourselves in the physical world must originate from our bodies, brains, material resources, and other physical entities, metaphysics teaches us that the true power to create what we authentically desire resides in the spiritual world and encourages us to engage in spiritual practices that allow us to embody the spiritual world while we reside in the physical one. For when we engage in spiritual practices, we go to the realm of love, solutions, and possibilities, and bring those qualities into the physical world, which enable us to anchor all the blessings of the divine on earth. This book will teach you how to become a metaphysician, that is, how to be someone who lives in the physical world, but channels and embodies the love, solutions, and possibilities of the spiritual world, regardless of your disability status, over the course of 8 chapters. Each chapter focuses on one spiritual practice and includes both a discussion of how.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.